How do we survive? How do we survive actually being in our inbox all day long? Because I don't really think it's a great idea for us to be sitting in our inbox all day long. I don't like that one bit at all. But I've got to admit, Google's done a pretty good job of bringing all these tools into one place. Well, I found a cool little plugin, and that plugin is called Inbox When Ready. And what this plugin does, and this is absolutely awesome, is it automatically hides your inbox. Now, if you have ever been in this situation, right? Maybe you're disciplined like me and you leave Gmail switched off for most of the day and you only go in there at certain points in, you know, at the day, but you need to search for an email or you need to compose an email. What do you have to do? You have to open your inbox. And what happens? Inevitably, you end up reading through your inbox and then you're distracted and you're removed from the task that you were doing. And when you just wanted to send an email or send a message or just find some information, all of a sudden you're dragged into inbox distraction land. And we all know that inbox distraction land is the world's to-do list for you, right? And it's just, it's a bad idea. It's terrible for productivity. So how can we actually fix that? Well, this plugin does exactly that. So you may have noticed when I was in my inbox, there was actually no inbox there. And this plugin has actually hidden my inbox for me. And it's not until I click this button, show inbox, that someone's even emailed me here. Thank you. And so we've actually got my inbox sitting here, hidden until I hit the show inbox button. Now, not only does it hide my inbox until I show it, it also, if I leave my inbox open, I can set a timer and I can say, hey, if I haven't touched my inbox in 15 minutes, automatically just hide it for me. So effectively, it's going to hide the inbox away, but let me do everything else I need to do. And let me tell you, this has been an absolute godsend over the period of the last week where I've dedicated myself to using Gmail full time, because it's meant that I've closed down all these extra tabs that I didn't need. I don't need to constantly flick between tabs. I can message my team and get access to them when I need to. If I'm writing an email and I need to grab something from Google Keep, it's right there. If I'm, you know, chatting to someone and chatting away and I need to see my calendar rather than flicking to the calendar tab, I can just always see my agenda there every single day. If I need to drop in a new calendar event, I can drop in a new calendar event, or I can respond to an invitation that someone sent there, because invitations pop up on the calendar once someone's put them in there. Even if you haven't accepted them, it'll just show up there on the calendar. And so I'm basically doing everything from right inside my Gmail, and this plugin is just hiding the most distracting part of actually sitting in Gmail all day long. So if you want to get access to that plugin, it's called Inbox When Ready. And so if you go to inboxwhenready.org, I believe there's a link in the live stream here, then you can add that plugin. Now, there is a paid version, I think, to do the timers and things like that. You've got to pay for the paid version. I can't remember what the pricing is, but whatever it is, I'm probably going to buy it. I can't expect it's going to be that much. There we go, $4 a month. Yeah, I mean, make a decision whether or not you think it's worthwhile. I'm likely going to buy that. Because I think it's pretty damn awesome tool. No signature, I'm not sure what that means. Oh, there we go. It appears that it's going to add a signature on there to your signature if you continue using it past the free period. But this is a damn cool tool, guys. They haven't paid me anything to recommend this. I don't get any kickbacks from this, but maybe we should. But that basically completes my Gmail inbox experience, and that allows me to compose emails, to search emails, even to go through my filtered emails, which still actually can be a bit distracting. So I'm going to try and find a way to cut down on that as well. But this just absolutely fixes the most distracting part of that. So if you're inside your Gmail and all you can see is like really, really old Hangouts, like the old Hangouts, like the one-on-ones that you had with people. And look at that, I've done a refresh and they've actually done the branding update has been applied. Cool. So if all you can see is your very old one-on-one Hangouts and you can't see any of your rooms, it means it hasn't been switched on for your domain. So we'll post a help guide down below on how to do that in your admin panel. But if you're a customer of our concierge service, you can just message our Facebook page and say, hey, I'd like the new chat switched on. We're actually going to switch this on for all of our customers unless they opt out in the coming weeks. But if you want to jump the gun, just drop a message into our team. If you're a customer, itgenius.com/chat, or you can find IT Genius on Facebook, send them a message and ask for the new chat to be enabled in your Gmail, and the team will go ahead and enable that for you. What do we use now for ticketing? So we are moving all of our ticketing to a tool called Hiver HQ. And so Hiver is a ticketing tool that is, well, it's a shared mailbox tool rather than specifically a ticketing tool. It's a shared mailbox tool, which does a lot more than you can do with just sharing one Gmail mailbox between multiple people. So we are a Hiver partner. If you are interested in that, check it out on our website, itgenius.com, and have a chat to our team about that. Whether or not we implement it for you, it still helps us to buy your licenses through us. So if you've been referred by us, please do let us know so we can help you out with that. But Hiver allows you to have inside your Gmail effectively a shared label system, and multiple people can look into those shared mailboxes and work on those collaboratively. So it lets you do things like a normal ticketing system will let you do, like guaranteed response times. It can let you assign an email to someone, so it's assigned for someone, and then when they log in, they just see things that are assigned to them. You can automatically have routing rules. You can also do internal notes on a ticket or an email that the customer doesn't see. So if you've got two or three people internally working on it, then you can do that. And of course it integrates with Copper, CRM, and all the other tools that we're using. So amazing tool. We've gone from, at one time we were spending nearly $1,000 a month on Zendesk, and it gets very expensive when you have 40 odd people using it. And we have switched to Hiver. Phenomenal cost saving, not only that, but also it's just a very, very lightweight app. It feels like you're just using email. And so rather than flicking between emails, and this is the stuff that's in the help desk, which for your staff is like two different systems that they got to use, makes things a lot easier. So that's what we're using. If you're interested in that, have a chat to our team, let them know you're interested in shared mailboxes. And we also have some videos on our YouTube channel about options for sharing mailboxes, either inside G Suite or using a third-party tool, and what the pros and cons are of the different options that are there. So best diary management tool, I mean, obviously you want to use Google Calendar, right? And so Google Calendar is what you use for your day-to-day stuff. There's an amazing, amazing hack for Google Calendar, and I'll drop the link in here for you guys. It's called Visual Planner, and it turns your Google Calendar into a yearly planner. I don't have time to go through that, but if you're a customer of ours inside Genius Academy, there's a whole training video on this, on how you can use it. But I'm gonna drop the URL in here for you guys, because you can see here basically what this does. Now, there's not much on my calendar right now because I haven't planned out much. I don't think many of us have. But you can see basically any of my all-day events show up as a event on this planner, and then it lets you do like a yearly planner here, which is pretty cool. So that's one of the best planning tools. I don't know if that was your exact question there. Let me drop that link in there so you guys can get access to that. That'll be in the comments or the description below for you. But in terms of actually scheduling and allowing someone to like book in on your calendar, Calendly is probably the best scheduling tool around right now. Easiest to use. Got heaps of great, momentum and plugins added onto there. So Calendly, if you haven't checked that one out, that's the best one.